Hi everybody, welcome to Chemboss tutorial. I am Arindam and our today's topic is Taft equation. So far I have already discussed about Hammond's postulate, Cartan-Hammett principle, Hammett equation, including some previous year's questions. In the description box you will find the link. Now this Taft equation is, you can think that is quite a modification of the Hammett equation. Okay, so what we can see, this Taft equation, you can consider it as the modification of Hammett equation. It is basically the modification of Hammett equation. I hope you have already got the clear cut idea about the Hammett equation, and you all know that what was the reference reaction there. So what was the reference reaction which has been taken by Hammett to give its relationship? This was the aromatic ester with meta or para substitution. Okay, so aromatic ester and what he did, a base catalyzed hydrolysis. So he studied this, and this base catalyzed hydrolysis is producing this one. Okay, so this is what he has got. So this is the reference reaction for the Hammett equation. And now today what we are going to just discuss, that how this equation can be modified. So over this case we need to consider about the substituent, okay, and the electronic effect, whether it is electron withdrawing or electron donating. So rather you can say that you can consider this overall part which is attached to the CO2T. So now whether this is electron donating or electron withdrawing, so that electronic effect was our primary criteria to discuss about the Hammett equation or Hammett relationship. So that is something which governs the value of the rho. So rho is something, if the electron density increases, rho value will be positive. If it is decreases, then rho value will be negative. Such like thing have already been covered in the previous classes. So these are some recapitulation of the previous class. Now this Hammett equation only consider the electronic factor, and there is one problem that it is not valid. You can't apply, so it is not valid for aliphatic esters. So for aliphatic ester you cannot apply Hammett relationship. But point is that this Taft equation modifies itself in such a way that it consider, this Taft equation considers both electronic factor and steric factor, and that is why here aliphatic esters can also be investigated with the help of Taft equation. So this is quite important for the basic introduction of the Taft equation. Now let's take a look at this. Suppose a ester I am taking, okay, some ester is there, this is RCO2 R dot, okay, and I am just performing hydrolysis in two mediums, one is your acid medium, another is your basic medium. So suppose first I am adding acid, so the hydrolysis is taking place in the acidic medium. So what you find that initially it will be something like this, okay, O dot and OH plus. In the next step, H2O molecule will attack over here, so this will basically produce OH and then OH2 plus, then OR dot, okay, and then what you find that from here H plus will be removed, so it is something like this, OH, OR dot and OH, and now this will come back to throw out this way. This OR dot minus is a good leaving group, so basically you are getting something like this, plus and OH over here, and this OR dot minus is present in the medium, so it will now grab this H plus, thereby producing something like this. So you are getting एसिड, कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड, दिस इज अ एसिड कैटलाइज्ड हाइड्रोलिसिस. ओवर दिस एसिड कैटलाइज्ड हाइड्रोलिसिस दिस स्टेप इज द रेट डिटर्मिनिंग स्टेप. ओके, नाउ इन द रेट डिटर्मिनिंग स्टेप यू कैन फाइंड दैट ओवर हियर अ पॉजिटिव चार्ज इज प्रेजेंट, हियर ऑल्सो अ पॉजिटिव चार्ज इज प्रेजेंट, सो देयर इज इफेक्टिवली नो चेंज इन द और नो सिग्निफिकेंट चेंज इन द इलेक्ट्रॉन डेंसिटी. सो इफ यू कंसिडर दिस आर डी एस द स्टार्टिंग मटेरियल एंड प्रोडक्ट बोथ आर पॉजिटिवली चार्ज्ड. सो इन दिस केस इफ यू कंसिडर द इफेक्ट ऑफ दिस आर ग्रुप यू कैनॉट कंसिडर द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक इफेक्ट बिकॉज वॉट एवर द इफेक्ट एक्सर्टेड ओवर द स्टार्टिंग मटेरियल द सेम इज इन द केस ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट. सो दैट इज वाई द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक इफेक्ट, so that electronic effect that cannot be considered over here. Now here steric effect plays an important role. Why? Because if you see this R group is present over here and it is a bulky group, so if bulkiness of this group increases, so you can see that over here with this carbon only three groups are present initially. And in this case, considering the same carbon, there are four groups are around it. So if this R is much bulky group, so if its bulkiness increases, then automatically the rate of reaction decreases because this is the rate determining step. So whatever the change in the rate is observed in this case, that will be reflected on the overall rate of the reaction. So this is called the steric effect or steric bulk. So bulkiness of the group, which is quite important with respect to the acid hydrolysis. So for acid hydrolysis of ester, steric effect is the major governing factor. Now suppose I am doing this hydrolysis in the base catalyzed medium. So base is now present. Now this has already been discussed in the previous class. So this will be the attack of the OH minus over here. So it is basically producing O minus, OH in this case, and O R dot. So now in the next step it will come back, it will just throw away this one. So basically you are getting this is, and in the basic medium it is obviously ionized to produce this kind of thing. Anyway, so over here you can see that this is a starting material and it is your RDS, rate determining step. And if you consider the charge, so initially it is neutral, but over here a negative charge is there. Look at this, there is a negative charge, so it is negatively charged product. So from neutral starting material you are getting negatively charged product, so electron density increases, and that is why this R, what is the nature of this R group or the substituent, this plays an important role over here. So whether it is stabilizing the negative charge or not, that actually that governs the rate of the reaction. So that is what we can see, that over here for base catalyzed hydrolysis, the electronic effect is to be considered. And here also if you consider the the central carbon atom, so over here around it only three groups are present, but in this case four groups are present. So steric effect also plays an important role. So we have to consider both effect over here. So for base catalyzed hydrolysis, this is for the base catalyzed hydrolysis, you have to consider both the electronic effect, and the steric effect. Clear? So this is what is the basic introduction of the Taft equation, and let's see how we can apply this equation in order to understand the steric factor of different groups or different substituents over there. Now in the Taft equation, there are two parameters. Before going to write down the equation, we have to just know about two parameters. One is your sigma star parameter, which is associated to the electronic factor. So this actually represents the electronic factor. And another one is the ES. So this is related to the steric factor. Okay, this is related to the steric factor. Now, like you know that, in case of the Hammett equation, we just used this ester. This is the aromatic meta or para substituted ester. So this was our reference compound. In the Taft equation you will see the reference reaction is with this one, CH3CO2ME, okay, methyl acetate, and we are taking H2O over here. So this is something in the acid catalyzed hydrolysis, so it is producing CH3CO2H. Now what you are just getting over here, suppose the rate constant is represented as KME. So ME is nothing but this methyl group. You are just representing this is the rate constant of the reaction. And we are taking some general reaction with some R group, okay? Some R substituent is present, and we are just doing the similar kind of reaction over here. So to get the hydrolyzed product, and in this case I am taking the rate constant as KX, okay? So in this case the rate constant is KX. So I am taking the notation from your book, so you can write it as KR as well. So over here X is basically R, the substituent. X represents the substituent. And if you focus on the expression for the ES, it is something like log of KX by KME. So this is the rate constant for reference reaction, and it is the rate constant for X equals to R. So any substituent R, that kind of ester. So this is what you are getting from the steric factor ES. Now there are two things. Suppose this R is bulky. So if R is bulky, suppose this R is bulky group, okay, bulky, or you can think that it is more bulky than methyl. So this is your reference. So whatever the bulkiness you are considering with respect to the methyl group itself. So if it is more bulky, okay, bulky than methyl, so the steric factor just slow down the rate. So you can see that this KX will have the lower value as compared to KME because of the bulkiness increases. So that will decrease the reaction, slow down the reaction. So over here what you are actually getting, this value of ES, which is basically log of KX by KME, which will be negative. Okay, now when we take R equals to ME, that means methyl itself, so then KX equals to KME, okay, so our reference reaction, so in this case ES will be 0, log 1 equals to 0. And the third case, when R is less bulky, so when R is less bulky as compared to the methyl, then the reaction will be, the rate of the reaction will be greater. So for this case ES will be positive. Okay, so I am just highlighting these points, and I will suggest you to take the screenshot of this. So these highlighted points are quite important. Okay, and just take the screenshot of this page. Clear? Okay, so now suppose I am writing a generalized equation. Over here H2 is there and the hydrolysis is taking place. Okay, and now what I am saying, that suppose R, I am taking different R group and just considering the value of the ES. So suppose I am taking R equals to H, hydrogen. So you know that our reference was this one, CH3CO2ME. Okay, now over here instead of R dot, let's just take it as a methyl. Okay, so that will be much easier for us to compare with our reference reaction. So over here the methyl was present, but in this case R is present, R is H. So hydrogen is less bulky, so obviously you can see that ES, if R is less bulky than methyl, then ES will be positive and the value of ES will be 1.24. Now when R equals to methyl, what I said over here, value of ES will be 0. Suppose R is ethyl. For ethyl, ethyl is more bulky than methyl, so it will be negative value and it will be minus 0.07. For isopropyl group, you can see it is minus 0.47. And for tertiary butyl group, it is minus 1.54. So this is according to your bulkiness. I am plotting this one. Now remember that these values are not important. You need not just remember or mug up those values. what you need to understand that whether it is more bulky or less bulky, and that is the order of the value of the ES. Now in this case, you see, if I consider pH phenyl, so you will get it is -2.55, so it is more bulky than tertiary butyl. Okay, so it is quite important. And if I take CH to pH, so it is even lesser bulkiness over there, so it is 0.38, -0.38, so something like this. So over here, what you are getting, the order of bulkiness, you will see this H is the least bulky, then methyl, then ethyl, and after that you are getting CH to pH, and then you are getting isopropyl, then tertiary butyl, and pH between among all of these, the pH will be the most bulky. So this is what you are getting, the order of the bulkiness. The order of the bulkiness is represented over here. So there may be question from this concept as well. Clear? Now what about this sigma star, that is the electronic factor. So this is sigma star is 1 by 2.48 log of kx by kme for basic hydrolysis, okay, basic hydrolysis, minus log of kx by kme for acidic hydrolysis. Now I just said that for the reference reaction, that means with this one, the rate constant is kme, and for some substituent over here, instead of methyl, the rate constant now becomes kx. Now I'm comparing these two rate, and I'm getting the value of the ES. ES is the steric factor, okay? So that is what I have discussed so far. Now what I said, that for ester hydrolysis, whenever you are considering base catalyzed hydrolysis, in that case it consider both steric factor and electronic factor. Okay, both steric factor and electronic factor of the R group is to be considered. But when the same hydrolysis is taking in the acid catalyzed medium, so in this case what you can see that you have to consider only the steric factor. Now if you consider this expression for the sigma star, you will find out that this is a base catalyzed system, and for base catalyzed hydrolysis you have to consider both steric factor and the electronic factor. But in case of the acid catalyzed one, you have to consider only the steric factor. You are talking about the same substrate, so in both the cases you are taking the same substrate. So if you just subtract these two factors, so steric factor will be ruled out and you will only get the effect of the electronic factor. And that is what the expression for the sigma star represent. So this is all about your Taft equation. That's all for today. I hope you just liked my video. If you liked it, then don't forget to share and subscribe. Thank you. Happy learning.